In this video, we are going to talk about principle of OOPS. So OOPS stands for Object Oriented Programming. So there are four major principles. First one is abstraction. Second is inheritance. Third one is encapsulation. The fourth one is polymorphism. We will try to explain each one of these step by step and with a real life example. So let's see. Abstraction. What is abstraction? Abstraction is hiding the implementation details from a user with a better UI. UI is user interface. So providing a good user interface so that user can just work on that and is abstracted from the real implementation of the software. So real life example is like you are having a washing machine and you just know that how to turn it on, how to put clothes, how to set the timer and how to set the wash time, and just you will get dry clothes. So you are totally abstracted from the working of the washing machine, how it is working, what is the motor power, what are various constituents. You don't need to understand about it. You have just paid for the machine and you just know how to operate on machine. So OOPS says that a developer must give a better abstraction to the user, a better UI to the user, and user must be abstracted from the implementation details, and just a better UI can help in understanding the and working of the software. So second is inheritance. Now inheritance model says that if there is an already existing class, that class property and methods can be used by a new class. Just like take a real life example, there is a vehicle. Now vehicle's property, vehicle is a base class, vehicle's property can be used in a truck, in a car, and as well as in a bike. Now vehicle is a base class which can serve truck, car and bike. More real life example is father and son. So both are humans, but father is a base class. All the properties, all the attributes, all the functions that a father can do, its son can also do. So this principle is called as inheritance. So a derived class, a new class, can exhibit some new features while accessing the old ones from the base class. So this is the concept of inheritance. Encapsulation. Encapsulation says encapsulating both data members and methods of a class together in a unit. So creation of class itself is some sort of encapsulation. So this is very important to understand that when we combine two things into one pack, into one unit, we are doing encapsulation for that. Fourth point is polymorphism. Poly means many and morph means forms. So polymorph, one thing which can be implemented in different ways. So let's suppose you are going to sum two variables or two numbers. Now you take to create a method, sum for that. Now that method sum can be based on integers, can be based on floating points, and can be based on some other data type also. So you need to understand that how this polymorphic nature is exhibited in the real life, and the same we try to incorporate in programming. So basically these four principles are related to our real life. How real life modeling is done in OOPS. These are the four pillars, or you can say the four principles of that. I'll try to explain through code each one of these.
So guys, let's start with the method overloading. So I've created a class testSum and I've created two methods, intSum int a int b and intSum int a int b int c. So here in this function there are two parameters, and in this function we are having three parameters. So with this we can say that these two methods are overloaded, right? Now what is the syntax of calling a method? It is object dot method name. For that you need an object. So how to create an object? I want to call the method int sum of class test sum. So I have to create an object of test sum. So what is the syntax? Class name, object name, new operator, and the constructor. So object is created. So now obj dot sum. Now you need to pass the arguments. So now what number of arguments to call the first sum function? That is 2. So let's say 20, 30. So you have given the two parameters. Now easily you can see this function will be called and something will be returned, that is 20 plus 30 50. So you can always store that result into a variable, let's say res. So int res equal to obj.sum 20, 30. So this is your first call. Second call, let's say res2, let it be res1, and res2 equal to same obj.sum. Now what you will do to call this method having three arguments, so you have to pass three values of integer type. So let it be 20, 30, 40. It is not a mandate to give this serial wise. You can pass any value, let's say 65, no problems, right? So you need to pass only three values here. It can be any integer values. See, the name of the function is same, but where is the difference? The difference is in its signature, right? So function overloading depends on the signature of a function, right? So signature is very important. Signature further has three things. One is number of arguments, second is type of arguments, and the third is arrangement of arguments. So here we are doing with number of arguments. We are changing the number of arguments. In the first function we are having two arguments, in the second function we are having three arguments. So accordingly we have to call these. So here you can see system.out.println, the sum is res1, and the same with the res2. So let's save this file as methodoverloading.java. Go to cmd, change your drive, change the folder. Java C is your compiler. Java C, file name .java. So methodoverloading.java. So compilation done. Now run the program. So the sum is 50 and the sum is 115. You can easily see 20 plus 30 is 50 and 50 plus 65 is 115. So this is the simplest example of method overloading or function overloading. I hope you have understood the simple concept of polymorphism, that there is one method which is having same name, that is sum, and it is exhibiting different forms. One is having two arguments, another is having three arguments. So there is a change in the number of arguments. Thank you so much.